Thank you. Please have a seat.
Allison and Gary, today all of us are gathered to witness your marriage and to share in the joy of this occasion, which is one of the most memorable and happy days of your lives. As you know, no minister, no priest, no rabbi, no public official can marry you. Only you can marry yourselves. You can do this by a mutual commitment to each other, to work toward creating an atmosphere of care, consideration, and respect, and a willingness to face the challenges that underlie human life. Together, you can make your wedded life come alive. On this, the day of your marriage, you stand somewhat apart from all other human beings. You stand within the charmed circle of your love, and this is as it should be. But love is not meant to be the possession of two people alone. Rather, it should serve as a source of common energy, as a forum in which you find the strength to live your lives with courage and joy. From this day onward, you must come closer together than ever before. You must love one another in sickness and in health, for better and for worse. But at the same time, your love will give you the strength to stand apart, to seek out your unique destinies, to make your own special contribution to the world, which is always a part of us and more than us. Today, as you join yourselves in marriage, there is a vast and unknown future stretching out before you. The possibilities and potentials of your married life are endless. And now falls upon your shoulders the task of choosing values and making real the moral dreams that other men and women have engendered and died for. In this way, you will create the meaning of your life. If your love is vital, it will make the choosing and acting easier for you. In traditional religions, it is customary to call down a blessing upon the bride and groom. All of us here today give you our blessings. But I know that you share with me the conviction that how two people love one another and treat one another, and how they contribute to the community of men and women, is more important than their formal religious beliefs. I should like at this time to speak of the many things which all of us wish for you. First of all, we wish for you a love that makes both of you better people, that continues to give you joy and zest for living, that provides you with the energy to face the responsibilities of life. We wish for you a home, not just a place of stone and wood, but an island of sanity and serenity in this frenzied world. We hope that this home is not just a place of private joy and retreat, but rather serves as a temple wherein the values of your life are generated and upheld. We hope that your home stands as a symbol of humans living together in love and peace, seeking truth and demanding social justice. We hope that your home encompasses the beauty of nature, that it has within it the elements of simplicity, exuberance, beauty, silence, color, and a concordance with the rhythms of life. We wish for you a home with books and poetry and music, a home with all the things which represent the highest strivings of men and women. Finally, we wish at the end of your lives you will be able to say these two things to each other. Because you have loved me, you have given me a faith in myself. And because I have seen the good in you, I have received from you a faith in humanity. I shall now ask you for your marriage vows.
Allison, I promise to work as hard as I can to give you everything that you want in this life. I promise to love and respect you forever. I will always push us to be the best that we can be together. I promise to be a loving husband and father, especially to Mia. I promise that eventually I'll get over wanting Gary Ivan Smith III. I promise to make sure there's always a puppy or two in the home. I promise that wherever we choose to live, I will give my all to make it our perfect home. I'm so proud of you and all that you've accomplished. You amaze me every day, love. I will devote the rest of my days to making that you happy that you said yes to me.
I promise to trust you fully and support your dreams. I promise to create a home with you filled with love, laughter, and understanding. I promise to listen to you, to learn from you, and to push you to always be your best. I promise to continue to improve upon my arguing skills so you can continue to practice litigating at home. I promise to stay by your side no matter how hard the battle. I promise to be there at the end of a long day, to laugh with you, to cry with you, and to just be with you. I promise to faithfully love you always and forever.
Gary, will you have Allison to be your lawfully wedded wife in all love and honor, in all duty and service, in all faith and tenderness, to live with her and cherish her and love her in the bond of marriage?
I do.
Allison, will you have Gary to be your lawfully wedded husband in all love and honor, in all duty and service, in all faith and tenderness, to live with him and cherish him in the bond of marriage?
I do.
Join your right hands. Gary, repeat after me. I, Gary, take thee, Allison.
I, Gary, take thee, Allison.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
And I do promise and covenant.
And I do promise and covenant.
To be your loving and faithful husband.
To be your loving and faithful husband.
In plenty and in want.
In plenty and in want.
In joy and in sorrow.
In joy and in sorrow.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
Allison, repeat after me. I, Allison, take thee, Gary.
I, Allison, take thee, Gary.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
And I do promise and covenant.
And I do promise and covenant.
To be your loving and faithful wife.
To be your loving and faithful wife.
In plenty and in want.
In plenty and in want.
In joy and in sorrow.
In joy and in sorrow.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
Do you have the rings? Gary, place this ring on Allison's finger. Allison, you are my beloved and my friend.
Allison, you are my beloved and my friend.
Allison, place this ring on Gary's finger.
No.
You're my beloved and my friend.
You are my beloved and my friends.
By the authority committed unto me, I declare that Gary and Allison are husband and wife. May kiss the bride.